Better Breed Australian Terrier. The Avengers in Terrier. The Bull Terrier from the Pets. And the Miniature Bull Terrier. The Chessie is coming in now, followed that by the Dandy Inmont. Then we have the Glenn Mar and the Irish Terrier and the Kerry Group. The Irishman Terrier comes next. And the Manchester. And we now, out of place here, but please tell them, the Border Terrier. And now comes the Norwich Terrier and the Hart and Russell Terrier. The Scottish comes next. The Seaman Terrier. The Sky. The Stockbridge Region, the Staffordshire Bull Terrier, Big Chair Service as usual, the White Terrier, the White Fox Terrier, and the West Highland White Terrier. And there we have our Terrier Best of Rooms. And now our Terrier Group Judge Harley leads an introduction. She's very much on her home territory in North Yorkshire. Patsy Hollings.
Fighting with a rat. There is our winning Bedlington Terrier,
number 795. Border Terriers here today for breed specialist Margaret Curtis. The Border Terrier, very much a functional working terrier. His otter-like head, a thick skin or pelt, and thick protective coat. Wiry on the outer coat, a tail like a carrot. There's the winning Border Terrier, the bitch number 819, a blue and tan. Now looking at the Bull Terrier sent forward by specialist Mrs. Sands. She chose this bitch, the white bitch, number 936. With the unmistakable profile of the head, egg-like in shape, this strong down face, sharply pricked ears, and relatively small eye, giving it a very mischievous expression. The Bull Terrier is a mixture of terrier and bull breed, so they have much more substance than a lot of terrier breeds. And there she goes, our winning Bull Terrier, 936. And now the same, but in miniature, on the table, the miniature Bull Terrier. Proving typically and full of character on the table. They share the same standard, but preferably a maximum height of 14 inches. And sometimes the judge will measure them in the ring. As I said earlier, one of the great challenges is to get the same qualities, but in a smaller scale. The miniature Bull Terrier Club had a fantastic centenary event recently with miniature bulls all over Europe. They're great characters as a breed. This one a brindle. Our miniature bull sent forward by Roger Thomas is number 950. Now on the table, the Chesky Terrier, Roger Thomas, judged seven of them, and he chose the dog, number 965. This is a breed which was developed, and its name suggests, in the Czech Republic, what was the Czech Republic, and originates from a crossing of a Scottish Terrier with a Sealing Terrier. And it has attributes from both. Rectangular body, the silver or blue or black coat, and if you like terriers that don't draw hand stripping, it's quite permitted to clip the coats of the Chesky, leaving the furnishings on the head, face, sides and legs. And this lower tail carriage is quite typical and quite permitted in the breed. The winning Chesky Terrier, number 965. Thank you.
now on the table, the Dandy Dinmont Terrier. An entry of 19 for Mr. McGee, and he chose the bitch number 982 as best of breed. This is another terrier with a distinctive outline. First of all, the large head and large dark eyes, and its body, which is quite long and weasel-like, with an arch over the loin and a fall away to the tail set. A crisp coat. There was really its work on the vulnerable list, but now becoming a little more popular, and of course, very endearing characters. Who could resist eyes like that? The winning Dandy Dinmont is the bitch number 982. And now for our really roughy, toughy terrier, the Glenny Vimal. Quite natural, substantial, big bone and powerful ribs and body. A strong skull and foreface. The front legs of the Glenny Vimal are slightly bowed, and it was thought that the slight bow in the leg gave them strength to pull out the quarry from their burrows. A native breed of Ireland. And it takes a lot of strength to lift one of those from the table. The handler agrees. There goes the distinctive, workmanlike Glenny Vimal. Wonderful characters, but with a lot of terrier spark to them when roused. There goes our winning Glenny Vimal number 1019. Now on the table, the Irish Terrier, sent forward by Mr. Watson. Our judge again checking the pads of the Irish Terrier. It's important that they don't have fissures or cracks or corns on the pads. The Racy Terrier, clean lined. Some length to the body and full of gameness. They used to be known as the daredevil of the terriers. This crisp wire coat and red, and there is the winning Irish Terrier. Alan Norcross judged 9 Kelly Blues today and chose this dog, number 1033, as best of breed. Another native of Ireland. And there goes the Kelly Blue. They're born black and gradually change to a silvery blue. The colour changing and starting to change around 18 months of age. Long, powerful foreface, relatively short in the body, and full of terrier beingness. Our judge now will be the Lakeland Terrier. 6 of them here today from Miss Kerrigan. She chose this bitch, number 1044 are the best of breed. And now, a breed which shows the diversity in the Terrier group, the Manchester Terrier. Smooth-coated, black and tan, the only colour in which we see it, this wedge-shaped head, the markings very specific, the black body with tan on head, legs, under the tail, and a distinctive thumb mark on the tan on the front legs. The outline of the Manchester is distinguished by a rise over the lawn, so don't expect an absolutely level back in the Manchester Terrier. Roger Thomas chose this dog, number 1050, as best of breed. And now the Norfolk Terrier has made the group, I'm pleased to say, from an entry of 33 for Mr. Mason. The winner in the Norfolks was this dog, number 1070. One of the smallest of the Terrier breeds, but within that small frame is a lot of substance. Relatively strong skull and short, strong foreface. Short in the body and well ripped. And one of the great challenges is to get with a short-legged dog is freedom of action. And as we see here, very much a mind of his own, this is Norfolk. A wagging tail and a forceful character. The winning Norfolk there, number 1070. The cousin on the table is the Norwich Terrier. Mr. Mason had an entry of 24 and chose the dog, number 1097. Until around the 1960s, the two breeds were shown as one. But finally, after much struggle and debating, they were separated into two separate breeds. And the trickier we see here is known as the Norwich Terrier. The black and tan we have here. Again, hobby in body and a chest. Full of spirit, but not quarrelsome with other dogs. There's the winning Norwich, number 1097. breed specialist Mr. Merrick judged an entry, a nice entry of 42 Parson Russell Terriers. His choice was this bitch, number 1137. This was a breed which originated in the West Country, taking its name from the founder, Parson Jack Russell. They were a fox terrier, but bear a lot of differences to our fox terriers, in that they are not as long or fine in the head, not as high set in the tail, with a marked rise over the loin. They come in wider or broken coated or smooth. Scottish terriers today, 19 of them, were judged by Mrs. Frances Chapman King. Her choice for best of breed was the bitch number 1169. A lot of substance under this harsh coat. Big ribs, powerful cold quarters. And his powerful hind quarters to drive it along. His good length of head and strength in the muzzle. The Scottish can be remarkably stubborn, or just as painted there, but are now motoring along, showing this lovely firm top line and excellent tail carriage. And there's our winning Scotty, number 1169. Five stadiums here today for Mr. Vickers. Our winner now on the table is the bitch, number 1177. The Seal is one of the native breeds of Wales, developed at Seal Manor near Haverford West. They were used and developed as vermin dogs, but I also see them working with packs of otter hounds. Again, a vulnerable native breed. But great characters and well worth all the work. Our winning seal there is number 1177. Mr. Thomas also judged six Skye Terriers, and the winner was the dog number 1182. By far the longest dog in the terrier group. It was a popular myth to call the Skye Terrier the yard dog. Canine folklore saying it should measure 36 inches from nose to tail. Long, low and level, and maintaining that level top line on the move. The breed made immortalized by the dog Green Friar's body, showing great loyalty to his master. When his master died, he went and lived at the graveside. native breed of Ireland, the soft-coated Wheaton Terrier, being examined now. Ronnie Irving judged 51 of them today. Nice entry for him. The winner is the dog number 1199. And the title of the breed tells you a lot about it. Soft is the texture of the coat, it's silky-ish. And Wheaton, the standard asks for the colour to be any shade of ripening wheat. And they should be presented not too over-trimmed. They should remain keep a rustic quality. Staffordshire Bull Terriers here today for specialist Mrs. Ward. Wonderful entry. Her winner was the bitch number 1384. This is another terrier breed which combines the bulldog, the bull breed, with the terrier mix. So they've got this strength in their head, strong cheeks, strong foreface. They combine substance with terrier-like qualities. And although they're terriers, they have wonderful temperaments with their family, devoted to their families. The winning Staffordshire Bull Terrier is number 1384. Welsh Terrier. Three of them here today for Mrs. Bakewell. She chose the dog number 1415 as best of breed. The Welsh Terrier comes in this rich black and tan or grizzle and tan and is a slightly larger, heavier version of the wire fox terrier. About the same height, but a little thicker set. Again, hard wire top coat, protecting the undercoat, and a crisp furnishing on head and legs. A judge just looking to see terrier spirit in the use of the ears, showing their alertness. The Fox Terrier Smooth from an entry of 10 is the dog number 988, sent forward by Mrs. Vickers. The ultra-smart, smooth fox terrier, hugely popular in the 1950s and the 80s or years. Short-backed, but with clean neck and shoulders, give it great classy outline, and a long, punishing, clean head. The smooth fox terrier there, is number 988. And the Why a Fox Terrier, again, Judge Barnes is because is a dog number 1004. Their standard is very similar to the smaller Fox Terrier. The principal difference, of course, is this crisp wire coat. And it takes a lot of work to get a wire Fox Terrier looking like this. Perhaps the reason why many of the wire-coated trim terrier breeds have fallen in popularity. In the 1950s, this was one of the most popular breeds of dog. But of course, society has changed, and perhaps people don't want to spend as much time trimming and keeping their dogs looking as smart as this. The winning Wire Fox Terrier. And now on the table, the final best of breed winner, the West Island White Terrier. 51 of them today for Ronnie Irving. He chose this bitch, number 1418, as best of breed. The West Highland White, one of the most popular terrier breeds as a household pet. Smart as paint, and made even more appealing by their dark pigment of nose and eye rings. And again, the shortness of the body and crisp outline, and the tail carried erect and showing great alertness and temperament. There is the winning Westie, the bitch number 1418.
The Irish Terrier. second spot. The West Highland White Terrier. The third place, the Canary Blue. And the fourth spot is the Norwich Terrier. So the Irish will be back on Sunday. The Irish Terrier, followed by the Westie.